So I started an experiment here. Figured I might as well stop and get the camera out and video a little. This is a little stob of fat wood that I pulled where the stob was sticking out of the side of a pine tree, a broken off branch. And I just sort of worked that little stob out of that pine tree trunk and had a little bit of fat in it, as you can see. Now this has been laying on the ground. It's been raining every day for the last 4 days. And this was laying on the ground back there, and where I had messed with it before and just sort of left it. And I was walking around here in the woods and picked it up and thought, hey, let's see how well it works after it's been laying in the water. And this board is soaking wet where it was laying here. And I scraped some shavings off of it, off of this piece of fat wood that's been laying out in the weather for several days in the rain. And piled them here. And let's see if they'll ignite. Question is, how am I gonna set this camera up? Okay, so there's the camera's on a tripod now, so I can do this with both, I can have both hands free. And just for the sake of those who maybe have never seen anything like this before, people who watch my channel, I'll show you that. You see the wood, and you see how there's like these oranger, darker orange color striations in it. That's where the sap has settled in at, and it's kind of hardened inside the wood, and it has a flammability to it that you wouldn't find in just plain wood, or especially not hardwoods. This is pine, and that turpentine sap, they call it, any place where there's been damage or injury to the tree, the tree sends it there, and then it settles in, kind of like creating a sealed off place from the injury to the tree. In this case, it was this branch was broken off, you know. It was just a small branch, and I just sort of dug it out of the tree and cut away part of it and focused in on this orangey looking stuff. And so what you do is you take the spine of your blade, kind of get it at an angle to where the sharp part's facing away from you, and you just kind of scrape on it like this. And you'll see that little shavings of that beautiful fat wood comes rolling off of there. And I'll just kind of roll the stick or piece of wood around as I go so that I get it from different places and kind of get a mix of some wood that doesn't have any fat in it, which will not combust very well, but will make fuel for the fire once you get it going. So there's that. And then getting more of the fat in there if I can. If this is good, still good fat. Remember I said this has been setting for several days in the pouring rain on the ground. So I just wondered. I can smell the turpentine from here though. Man, that smells so delicious. Funny, huh? The pine does have a wonderful smell. Brings back childhood memories of Christmas. We used to cut our trees live and put up a live pine tree. We weren't fancy pants like so many others around who had to have an artificial, couldn't stand the mess inherent in a natural pine. Of course, they miss out on that, but that's up to you, what you like. I know we have an artificial nowadays. It is a lot easier to deal with. But I do remember them good old days of the pine tree in our house, a live pine at Christmas time. Okay, so this is from the Walmart kit, where you can get the knife and the fire starter together. This fire starter that comes in this kit, you know, it's a cheap kit, only 10 bucks for the whole thing. And this is a decent knife. It's a good hard blade, and not as sharp as you probably would want. Not sharp enough to skin an animal or anything, but you can cut with it. It has a serrated section that comes in handy. But it's solid steel with some paracord wrapped around the handle for a little bit of comfort, not much. And this fire starter that comes with it only has a thin strip of flint. All of this around it is magnesium. A lot of people don't realize. You see it in the, when you see it in the pack in the store, you think, oh, well, that's a nice looking piece of fire starter. What they call ferrocerium rod. Actually, the ferrocerium rod is just this tiny sliver down through here that's glued in. And the rest is magnesium that you can scrape that magnesium off, and it's real combustible. But anyway, we're just going to use the fat wood for now and see what happens. Try to. Mosquitoes are starting to attack me. Too much talk. All right, here we go. And there it goes. And it's burning. Ain't that cool? But I see that I did knock some of the magnesium off as I was trying to scrape this thin strip of ferrocerium. Knocked a little bit of the magnesium in there, and I think that probably helped. But as you see the black smoke coming off of that shavings of fat wood, yeah, that's that sap burning. That stuff is combustible. It's pretty surprising. So there you go. It's something that you, if you were out in the wilderness unexpectedly, which seems unlikely, but in it, you know, stuff happens, I guess. But anyway, yeah, that's a survival tip. You can find a piece of pine with some fat in it and make these shavings and use your ferrocerium rod to set it on fire, or a match, or a Bic lighter, whatever you have that'll create enough heat to set that sap off and start it burning. You gotta have something that'll put out some heat. This ferrocerium, when it's scraped, those sparks, they say them things are in the thousands of degrees for heat. So even though they're a very fast and quickly ignited and quickly burnt out spark, they put off so much heat in that one tiny point for that one tiny instance that they can cause something to ignite, which is pretty cool. So this is also, I guess, a review of that set from Walmart. Let's scrape some of that magnesium off of there, don't we? Now I'm scraping the magnesium part of it, not the ferrocerium. And you see these shiny pieces of little shavings are flying off. So how much time do you got to spend on doing this? Well, depends on how easily you want your stuff to ignite and how wet the stuff is. Because if your tinder is really damp, like it would be on a day like today, forget about it. You're going to need a lot of heat to burn that moisture out and get that tinder dry enough to light up. So yeah. Use a whole lot of this magnesium. Now remember, this little table is soaking wet too. So I'm surprised really that wet fat wood lit up as good as it did, but wet fat wood will ignite apparently. That might be good to know. I've never actually done that before, but it was easy enough for me. Should be easy enough for anybody else. You know, it would probably be a lot harder in a real emergency situation. You just never know. You know how nature pulls against you. All right, now let's see how this ignites. Camera's still in good. Yeah, that should work. Woo! Look at that stuff burn. See how quick that magnesium lit up? But now that magnesium burns hot. That's why you can't put it out with water. Not when there's a real magnesium fire. But anyway, you see how quickly those little magnesium powder shavings lit up. The idea would be to have more tinder there that would catch fire. And would hopefully be able then to continue laying tinder on it and get it to burn. But I didn't go through all that trouble. Just showed you that you could get a good hot spark going. as they say, it only takes a spark to get a fire going. So anyway, that's the magnesium part of this Ferroserum or Firestarter rod in the kit from Walmart. Ozark Trail kit. It was $10. You get the knife and the starter. There's also a pretty decent sheath. It's actually a pretty quality sheath. I got another fire starter on there. That's a different one, though. But you can see the sheath is actually not half bad. And you can stick your fire starter stick in there. Take it with you. Then you put that on your hip, and you're good to go. Not too shabby for $10. Eh, just something to talk about. Thanks for watching.